What's up, foodies? Thank you so much for all the love you guys gave me on the last video. Now for today's recipe, I know everyone has been asking me to make some chicken dishes or some non-veg dishes. So here we go for today's recipe. We're gonna be making some butter chicken for you guys. So without wasting any more of your time, let's get to making the recipe. All right, guys. So the first thing we're gonna do to make chicken, butter chicken, it's we're gonna go ahead and marinate our chicken. So for marinating the chicken, what we are doing, it's I have cut the boneless chicken breast very, very thin. Now I'm gonna go ahead and add some salt to it. So we're gonna do salt to taste. With that, we're gonna go ahead and add some ginger paste. We're adding a little bit of garlic paste. On top of that, we're just gonna add a little bit of haldi. And we're gonna go ahead and add some Kashmiri chili. Now, traditionally, when you see people making butter chicken, you will see them using lime. I don't like using lime in my recipe, so what I'm gonna be doing is I'm actually gonna go ahead and use some yogurt. So I'm gonna go ahead and add about a spoon of yogurt to it. And then we're gonna go ahead and mix everything together. All right, guys, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and mix it up together like this. And once it's mixed, all we're gonna do is we're gonna let it sit for about 15 to 20 minutes. If you're gonna put it in the fridge, I usually put it in the fridge for marination to get stuck to the chicken. I usually put it in fridge if I'm making it quick. It takes about 10 to 15 minutes when you put it in the fridge or freezer. If you're not putting it in the fridge or freezer, the best way to get the marination going for with the chicken is leave it out for about 30 minutes, cover it and leave it out for about 30 minutes to 45 minutes, and you have perfectly marinated chicken. So while we're waiting on chicken to get marinated, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get started with our gravy. Let's show you guys how to make the gravy very, very simple. All right, guys, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and warm up some ghee in a pan. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put my my spices in there. So I have a little bit of clove. I have about 2 to 3 cardamom. I have about 3 to 4 cloves, and I have some black pepper in there. And we're gonna go ahead and just saute them just a little bit until the flavor comes out. And once we saute that, this is gonna be quick. If you're cooking on a high heat, it's not gonna take too long. All we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and saute this a little bit. And once you start hearing them crackle, at that point, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and add, I have some chilies in there. I have about 3 big chilies that I've chopped up. I'm adding onions. They don't have to be in any shape. If you just roughly chop them, that's completely okay, because we're gonna go ahead and grind them anyways. So we're gonna go ahead and toss this very quick. We're gonna saute it a little bit. While the onions are getting sauteed, what we're gonna add to it is we're gonna go ahead and add our garlic paste to it. So I'm adding about a spoon of garlic paste. We're gonna go ahead and give it a good mix. And now at this point, we're gonna go ahead and add our tomatoes to it. Give it a good mix, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and add our spices to this as well. Now, since we're making butter chicken, it doesn't need, traditionally butter chicken is not very spicy. The butter chicken is just very creamy and has it's a little bit towards the mild side. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and add just a little bit of spices. So I'm adding about a spoon of Kashmiri chili, a spoon, just a half a spoon, half a tablespoon of turmeric powder, just a little bit of turmeric powder. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add just a little bit of garam masala. Now at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and give this a good mix. And once I mix this just a little bit, I'm gonna go ahead and add some cashew nuts to it. I am adding cashew nuts only. You can also add, when you're making this gravy, you can also add a little bit of watermelon seeds if you want to. Watermelon seed, if you're not able to afford the cashew, then just go ahead and use the watermelon seed. Now for me, I'm using broken pieces of cashew. Cashew gives that creamy structure to your gravy. And once I do that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add one more spoon of ghee in there. So just a little bit more ghee. Give it a good mix, turn my heat to high now. I'm gonna give it a good mix and then I'm gonna let it cook and let it sit on a low to medium heat for about 10 minutes or so until the tomatoes are smooshy and start losing water. So let's go ahead and let it rest for a few minutes. Once the tomatoes start losing water and once the onions and green chilies are smooshy, our gravy is gonna be all set to go. All right, guys, so at this point, what we're gonna do, it's we're gonna go ahead and add some butter to it. As we know, the recipe is called butter chicken. So we are gonna go ahead and add butter to it. Now, the recipe I'm making today, we're gonna be making a one pan recipe. So what we're gonna do, it's we're gonna go ahead and let the butter melt, and then we're gonna go ahead and mix it up very quick. Yes, it's Diwali today, so yes, I am. I am fumbling a little bit, but you know what I mean. So we're gonna let the butter melt. And once the butter is melted, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and let this cool down. Once it's cool, we're gonna go ahead and make a gravy out of it. We're just gonna go ahead and fine grind it, make a fine paste out of it. I'm not gonna bore you with it already. I have shown you that in multiple videos before. So this time I'm not gonna go ahead and show you that. Now the reason why we're adding butter to the gravy, it's because of course it's called butter chicken. So without having the taste of butter, the recipe is incomplete. So at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and just let it simmer for one more minute on a low heat until the butter is melted. Once the butter is melted, I'm gonna go ahead and turn it off, let it cool down a little bit and make the gravy out of it. All right, guys, so we're using the same pan that we had for making the gravy. Now I have added about 1.5 spoon of ghee in there. Now I'm adding a little bit of butter in there as well. And then at this point, what we're gonna do, it's we're gonna go ahead and grill our chicken in the same pan. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take my chicken pieces that I have made. Just lay them down and we're gonna cook them about 90%. So the reason why we're grilling them is so the spices and all the masala marination that we have done, while we grill it, the masala actually sticks together to the chicken. If you just put the raw chicken in the food, yeah, it would definitely cook for you, but what it would do is it's not gonna go ahead and the masala is not gonna stick to it as well as it would when you grill it a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and grill the chicken. It takes about 3 to 4 minutes in grilling the chicken, so I'm not gonna bore you with that. We'll come back once we're done grilling the chicken. All right guys, so our chicken is ready. Now at this point, what we're gonna do, in the same pan that we have been using, we're gonna add one more spoon of ghee. We're gonna add tiny bit of butter more. And we're gonna let the butter melt. Once the ghee and butter gets melted, then we're gonna go ahead and start adding some of our spices to it. All right guys, so our ghee and butter has melted. And as you can see, the masalas and everything looks great. Now at this point, what we're gonna do is just, we're gonna go ahead and add just a tiny bit of jeera in there. And we're gonna let the jeera become aromatic. So we're gonna go ahead and let the jeera crackle just a little bit. And I'm gonna go ahead and use all the masala that has been crusted on the side as well. Now this is gonna add all the flavors that we have been adding to this dish from the beginning. All right, so I'm just waiting on my jeera to crackle. Now with that, I'm gonna go ahead and add just a little bit more spices to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and add just a little bit of turmeric powder and just a little bit of red chili powder. Now at this point, we're gonna go ahead and open the masala up. And once masala gets opened up, we're gonna start adding our gravy to it. Alright guys, so our masala has opened up a little bit. Now at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start adding my gravy to it. And we're going to use a funnel like this, and we're just going to go ahead and strain the gravy that we have made. Now I have made some extra gravy. As most of you know, I have a bunch of family member that's vegetarian. So I am making some vegetarian food as well, so I have some extra gravy in there. Now while I'm adding the gravy and straining the gravy, I'm going to go ahead and put my heat on low heat. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to go ahead and strain the gravy in there. Alright guys, so we have strained the gravy in there. The reason why we're straining the gravy in there, it's because butter chicken or chicken makkhanwala, usually when it's made, it is a very smooth, very silky recipe. So by straining the gravy, what it does is all the tomato seeds and chili seeds and everything that's left uncrushed, it gets pureed out of there. So we're gonna, at this point, what we're gonna do is we're gonna let the gravy cook a little bit. We're just gonna let it cook for like about another 2 to 3 minutes. We're gonna go ahead and taste it and make sure that we have enough salt in there. Taste your gravy, see if you need more salt or not. Use salt to your taste, but I do strongly advise that do taste it before you go ahead and add chicken to it. So we're gonna let it cook just a little bit more, then we're gonna add our cream to it, add some salt, and we're gonna be good to go. Alright guys, so once your gravy starts bubbling like that, all you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and turn your heat to the low. Now there is four more things we're adding, and we're gonna be all good to go. So now at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and add my cooked chicken. And with that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add, so for this recipe, I'm using half and half cream. The reason for using half and half cream, it's because I want the cream to cook a little bit. So that way when we, for next 5 minutes or next 10 minutes, when we're gonna let the chicken simmer a little bit, the gravy doesn't become too thick. So that's why we're gonna use half and half cream. So I'm gonna go ahead and add my cream to it now. I'm also gonna go ahead and add some butter to it, some more butter to it. Yes, butter chicken. So yes, we're gonna add a lot of butter. And the last thing we're adding is we're actually gonna go ahead and add some kasturi methi to it. So we're gonna go ahead and crush our kasturi methi and go ahead and get those final touches added to it. And we're just gonna let it simmer for next 10 to 15 minutes and our food is gonna be ready. All right guys, so this is how I like my butter chicken to look like, and this is how I want the gravy to be. This is perfect. All you serve this with is you can serve it with naan, you can serve it with rice, you can go ahead and serve it with roti, paratha. This is pretty much done. So as you guys know, the food is ready. I'm not waiting on you. I do want to wish everyone a very happy Diwali and a prosperous new year. I hope this new year brings you guys much needed health and all your dreams come true. Thank you so much. Until next time, have a great day.